Have you ever been so anxious and stressed about making a decision that has affected your entire day and made you not function suitably?
Well, that is how individuals with aboulomania feel on a daily basis.
Aboulomania, derived from Greek, is severe indecisiveness affecting one's ability to function socially. Many people with this condition suffer from anxiety, stress, depression, and mental anguish. Individuals may also have this condition due to factors such as fear of failure and a lack of confidence or information. The decision-making process results from communication between the prefrontal cortex, which is our working memory, and the hippocampus, which is our long-term memory. However, there are other regions of the brain that play essential roles in making decisions, but their exact mechanism of action are still unknown.
Often when people are faced with difficult decisions, they try to delegate it to someone else. Think asking a doctor to make a treatment choice for you, or having a waiter make the final call between two entrees you're considering.
They may also defer a decision or avoid choosing anything at all. This may be like buying the same shirt in two different colors when you can't decide on one, or not buying anything at all.
In fact, a paper published by Journal of Consumer Research shows just how far people will go to avoid a tough decision. They found that people may hope for relatively worse news in an effort to avoid difficult decisions. In the study, people are asked, imagine you're experiencing pain in your shoulder, and your doctor tells you that you've torn a tendon. If the tear is big, you'll need surgery. Whereas if it is slightly smaller, surgery is optional. Which size tear would you prefer?
70% of participants preferred a larger, more serious tear. That's because they were told that if the tear was large enough, the need for surgery would be mandatory. While if it was smaller, the ultimate treatment decision would be left to them. Although the study is about making medical decisions, these findings apply more broadly and across a variety of contexts. People face difficult, potentially life-changing decisions all the time, and the study findings show just how paralyzed one can feel when they are at a major crossroad.
This is akin to getting an acceptance from two prestige universities and secretly hoping that one will withdraw the offer so you wouldn't have to make a decision at all.
Next, we'll discuss how having lots of choices doesn't necessarily help with decision-making. In a book published in 2005 by Barry Schwartz titled The Paradox of Choice, Schwartz explores why more is not actually more and can sometimes make decisions much more difficult. According to Schwartz and extensive research, offering more choices creates a psychological barrier that may demotivate consumers, as more choices require more time and effort on the consumer's end to pick between options, in addition to an increased chance that the choice is wrong and ends up being regretted later on. This leads to the choice overload hypothesis, which suggests that, although the provision of numerous choices can be seen as initially desirable, once the number of choices gets too high, it can be unexpectedly demotivating. In a study conducted in 2000, consumers were exposed to a tasting booth with either 6 or 24 flavors of jam to choose from. Consumers were more likely to stop at the booth when there were a more extensive display of jams, but those who stopped at a lesser display were 10 times more likely to actually buy a jar. These findings challenge the fundamental assumption that having more choices results in one being more intrinsically motivated to choose or buy. So, how is there so much dissatisfaction when one is presented with so much opportunity? Although there is no concrete answer as of yet, some speculate that it's not because people feel unhappy of their choices when faced with so many options, but instead they are unsure of how to distinguish between a good and a bad decision. Interviews with American and Canadian citizens showcase that many are unsure of whether they are doing the right things with their lives, or even what those right things are, a sentiment exacerbated by being overloaded with choice and choice-making contexts.
Next, we'll be tackling indecisiveness and its relation to other mental health disorders.
The three main mental health disorders that we chose to focus on are anxiety, depression, and neuroticism. Anxiety can be categorized by feelings of tension, worry thoughts, and increased blood pressure. One study found that indecisiveness paired with anxiety scale scores accounted for a significant proportion of career indecision.
Depression is a persistent feeling of sadness and a loss of interest. One study found that people experiencing depression may be more inclined to act irrationally and are more likely to be indecisive. Lastly, neuroticism relates to individuals that may experience a variety of different things, such as depression, anger, and anxiety. One study found that those experiencing neuroticism also score the highest in regards to indecisiveness. This means that there's a high correlation between these two variables.
For those who find themselves wrestling with making difficult decisions, rather than hoping for bad outcomes, a better strategy may be finding ways to make the choice easier. This could be by gathering more information or seeking counseling. Other researchers have found that choice closure can help reduce regret and increase choice satisfaction. Simple examples can include closing the menu after you've chosen your entree, or not continuously checking on how a company is doing after you've rejected their job offer. So, in other words, acceptance.